Well, hello everybody, and welcome to our second live stream of Robert Harding's concert. We're really happy to have him here, and I hope you enjoy the concert. So here's Robert.
Thank you, everybody. Let me get this guitar in shape here. It was very nice to stretch it out on that piece by Hector Villalobos. It's his first prelude. He left us 5 preludes, 12 etudes, and that was just the first prelude. And I think I'm going to play the next is a piece by Moreno Torroba, and it's from his Castles of Spain pieces. This is a set of works that was written in mainly an album in 1974 of Andrés Segovia. The music is quite nice and very pretty, and it also highlights the sound of this guitar. So the first of the couple of pieces is called Torija, or Elegy. Thank you very much. Thank you. It's very nice to have people here today, and everything's running great. Yes. No, it's great. It's really great. I'm going to put on a capo on the second fret here. This guitar has a particularly great 6-string F sharp. And this piece is also by Moreno Torroba, and it's from another set of pieces called the Piece Characteristics. And I heard Segovia play this in Jones Hall in Houston. Thank you. Thank you. The name of that piece is Bergolisa. And I put it, the capo on the second fret. It just sounds really nice, but I have historical reasons to do it. It was once published in F sharp major. And if you go and do a little researching online, you'll find there's kind of a lot of discussion out there on how to play it best in E or F sharp. And F sharp's so very hard. I'm thinking, just put a capo on and play the E, and you got it. Anyway, I'd like to play some Bach pieces now, two Bach pieces, a prelude in D minor, and then pair it with a jig also in D minor, but from the second partita for the solo violin by Johann Sebastian Bach. So, hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Thank you. I would like to play a couple of pieces in drop D. Only have three pieces today in D minor. Two of them in D minor. This piece here is an arrangement of Manuel de Falla's Song of the Will of the Wisp, which is a segment from a larger work called Love the Magician. And it's about love potions and magic and incantations. And this has to do with the Will of the Wisp, which there's some lore around that plant, that it's a bit of a siren plant, and it plays a role in the song. Anyway, Gil Evans also arranged this for Miles Davis's Sketches of Spain, but I'm playing Emilio Pujol's arrangement. Thank you very much. Thank you. Having a great time today. The next piece is a piece written by the man who arranged that, his teacher, Francisco Tárrega. And it's one of his pieces called Capricho Árabe. And it celebrates the influence of the Moorish culture upon Spain and its mark on the music and the feel and all the architecture and everything else about it. And it's his little tribute. And he wrote this towards the end of the 19th century. Thank you. And now we'll have a word from Julia.
Hello, everybody. I'm Julia Salser, the other half of House Concerts and the Arbors, and we sure wish you were here with us because this is absolutely thrilling. Wanted to let you know that we do have some concerts still coming up this season, which, based on the success that we have with this live streaming, we probably will be doing live streaming from here on out. And hopefully at some point we will have people in the house again. So the next concert that we have coming up is Adam and Chris Carroll, and they will be here on July the 19th. And then our folks coming in the fall, in October and November, are all touring musicians, and we don't know if they're going to be able to be here or not. We hope so. On the 4th of October, we have Honey House from New Mexico. And the 8th of November, we have the Rifters from Alamosa, Colorado. If for some reason they cannot be here with us, then we have people standing in line wanting to come and play for you. And so we'll announce that and probably a few other concerts that we may try to move in time when we can get them here. So we've already booked 2021. And I want to let you know ahead of time who we're expecting. January the 17th, we will have Sisters Morales. For Valentine's, February 14th, Dana Cooper, we hope. March the 21st, Susan Gibson will be with us. And for our Mother's Day concert on May the 9th, it will be Javier Chaparro and Salud. June the 13th, we have Hamp and Janet coming in from Beeville. July the 18th, we have Beetroot Revival. August the 15th, we have George Inslee and Greg Whitfield. And then November the 28th, we did this a couple of years ago with great success. We'll have Terry Hendricks and Lloyd Maines for After Thanksgiving. So that's what 2021 looks like so far. But I hope that you will come to us either in the house or by live stream. If you'd like to be on our mail list, we're happy to add you. Just go to www.arborshouseconcerts.org and ask to be on the list, and we'll get you signed up. So thank you again, and we're going to give it back to Robert.
Thank you, Julia.
Tell us about your CD and all that.
Oh, yes, thank you very much. I'm having such a good time playing. I do have a CD that many of the items, pieces I'm playing today, including the next one, are on this CD. Very proud of the artwork on it. A man named George Toomer did it, and it's rather unusual, and it looks a little like something George Crumb might have done in the blues series, although that wasn't asked for. That's just something George did. And anyway, I'm going to sell them today for $12. That will include the cost of shipping and so on. And you see on the screen there on how to get it. And thank you very much. And also, I'm available to play. I'm hungry to play anytime, anywhere. I also would love to work with anyone on their playing. So I believe the contact information is available, and otherwise, I want to play a wonderful piece by Agustin Barrios, a great genius of the guitar and his writing, which has only been rediscovered up in North America and Europe since the 70s. This is a three-movement work called The Cathedral, La Cathedral. He initially wrote it as a two-movement work. The first movement, though, is dedicated to his wife, and it's very, very pretty. He wrote it later in his life, and he stuck it at the beginning as kind of a prelude for this. In fact, the name of it is Prelude Sunday. So I wanted to be sure to tell you that. The middle movement is actually the beginning of the conception of the cathedral. It's supposed to evoke a feeling of being in a big city cathedral and hearing the music of Bach played on the organ. I'm not quoting the music, but that feel. The last movement, the third movement, is a contrast of that sort of serenity, as if you were on a big city street. In this case, it was Montevideo. But I did this in Chicago, went into a cathedral and happened to hear the music on the organ being played. And then I walked back out and I thought, this must be what he meant. Anyway, all this talking is only about 6 minutes. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Yes, I would like to play another piece by Agustin Barrios, perhaps one of the most beautiful pieces that I play, I think. And it's known as the Alm for the Love of God, and it has another title. It's also known as the Ultimate Canto, the last song. He evidently wrote it right towards the end of his life, which he lived to be 59, and that's what I just turned a couple of days ago. So, but I tend to stick around a little longer. He is a brilliant writer, and there is perhaps at least three parts in the middle of all this texture, and I'll try to bring it out. It's so beautiful. It's called an Alm for the Love of God. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm so happy everybody's tuned in, and those who will tune in the future, and I hope you've enjoyed this presentation. I would love to thank the host for inviting me to be part of the House Concerts in the Arbor series, so thank you. Really great. I'd like to finish today with a piece. It's got several titles for no other reason except for publishing. It happened to be a prelude at the set of a descriptive pieces that Isaac Albéniz, the Spanish composer and pianist, wrote. And it's clearly imitating the texture of the Spanish guitar. And we lifted it right away. As soon as it was published, we started to, Francisco Tarraga and those people started to play it. It fits really well. When I was in Spain, we went to the conservatory there in Madrid, and the person who was with us, guiding us there, went downstairs and found somebody in the basement practicing and brought him up and made her play this piece for us because we were a bunch of guitar players. And so that was, I think, the first time I'd heard it live on a piano, and it was very inspired, especially in the middle sections, because at that time I didn't really hear a lot of this in the guitar stuff. So hope you enjoy it. The name of this that I'm going to choose is Leyenda, or Legend. The Legend of the Tuning Man. Sounds so much better in tunes. Thank you.
you been playing, Robert?
About 45 minutes.
How old were you when you started playing?
I was pretty late. I started playing electric guitar, you know, Allman Brothers and all that stuff. I loved it. I had a 335 when I was 17, 18. And then I went to a school after high school down in San Antonio called the Southwest Guitar Conservatory, run by Jackie King and Herb Ellis. And there was a classical guitar class there. So I found myself awake all night trying to make these one-page pieces sound good. And I figured there was something to this. And so I could continue my habit in the education and get a degree and a couple of degrees and keep playing, you know. So, yeah. So since I was about 21, and I'm 59, so whatever that math is.
And how do we can contact you to hire you?
Oh, well, I think you have a little poster right here. Over here, yeah, here it is, right here. And the phone number is down there and the email, and I'd love to hear from you.
All right.
Even comments about the play or any questions, anything. I'll tell you what kind of strings I use. I can't do it right now.
Okay, so that concludes today's concert. Thank you again for Robert.
You got your one.
All right. Don't forget Adam and Chris Carroll coming up. So check the website, and we'll see you next time.